The most beautiful crowns are the most fleeting ones.
The Laws and Customs of the Great Council in the Kingdom, page 70. The Great Council elects a speaker for the Council for 4 years at a time. For diplomatic reasons, they may be called Queen or King or the Royal when dealing with foreign ambassadors who do not understand our customs. In the event of the Great Council being unable to elect a speaker, an emergency chancellor may be elected. They would function as acting queen or king or the royal until the Great Council is able to come to a decision. History of the Kingdom, page 256. After the old king died, there were too many claims to the throne, all too weak. The wise wizards and the lower council felt the threat of civil war was too great, especially after an undead rising. They united their forces and created the Great Council, which would rule the kingdom and ensure peace in the realm for all days to come. Amadeus and Pontius were ready to step forward.
It's planking time, wizard.
And it's time I stomp my foot down.
wanking time, wizard.
And it's time I stomp my foot down.
It's planking time, wizard.
And it's time I stomp my foot down.
What is this? Thievery!
Leading logistics mode, engaging combat mode. Undarge.
They were packing up the baubles in the royal treasury.
But why?
Stealing, and probably not for themselves.
Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya would all have to do their bit.
Didn't I just learn something useful?
A steel ball, Amadeus.
Zoya, we need your rope.
And I could use my ricochet arrows.
Thank you.
rise and shine. Alert! On guard!
That smirking skunk again.
Ah, the heroes of Trine. And not a moment too soon. Lady Sunshine Crownsdale has done something with the Great Council members. They have all disappeared, and I hear the wizards aren't doing too well either.
No! She has literally obliterated the Astral Academy!
Wait, who are you?
Oh, I'm just a humble civil servant and engineer. Lord Godric's the name.
What can we do to help?
Lady Crownsdale controls the clockwork knights that do her bidding. There's a device in the tallest tower here in town which sends the clockwork knights their orders. If you could destroy the device, then the clockwork knights would be harmless, and Lady Sunny would be without her army.
So how did you come by this piece of information?
I beg your pardon, madam. Do you doubt me? Like I said, I'm a civil projects engineer. It is my business to know these things.
Let's go and destroy that infernal machine!
The best of luck to you. May you reach the top of that tower.
Following the advice given to them by Lord Godric, the three heroes headed for the tallest tower. There, on top of the tower, the heroes would be able to turn off all the villainous clockwork knights and make things right again at last.
Where did all these clockwork knights come from?
The big old council decided to man the town with them. Most of the real knights were sent away to the Bastion of Hope.
But who made the clockwork knights? Not really seeing Sunny cranking up automatons knee-deep in machine oil.
Interesting question.
Thank you.
know. Why are these blocks floating like this?
That, my friend, is because of a levitation enchantment. Very rudimentary, of course, and couldn't possibly replace a powerful wizard. One of those gravity-shifting boxes again. Zoya, would you like to help me solve this?
Knighthood shall return soon, once we are rid of these deviled machines.